The topic today, we're asking people, what's the big story in your local news? Obviously, there's a lot of news going on here in Washington with the government shutdown and all that, but we're curious, what's going on in your country? What's the big story in the news today?
For today we are congratulating Sacrifice Day in our country. And it's a holy holiday in our country, and we are celebrating this holiday. How to say? Visiting our relatives, and so sacrifice. We sacrifice sheep for the sake of God, and it's a tradition in our country.
The Eid is tomorrow in Pakistan. Tomorrow is the Eid al-Adha in Pakistan,
mm-hmm.
And we are preparing for it. And people are, as you know, that the Muslims sacrifice animals on the Eid al-Adha, and on the roads and in the markets, you will see the people buying animals for sacrificing.
And do you have any? Would you have any special plans? Will you be spending Eid with your family?
Yeah, obviously I am off from the office, and I came home last day, and I will celebrate Eid with my family, and the activities will be to visit a relative, and there will be a gathering, and we usually celebrate 3 days. We celebrate Eid in 3 days, but the first day is special one, when the Muslims offer prayer, Eid prayer, and sacrifice their animals, and relatives come, or you have to visit your relatives.
Like, I'm Sicilian, I'm originally Nigerian, but I'm living right now in Egypt. So, you know, the situation in country is not like before. Before, we can visit our friend, Egyptian brothers, our friend, they are living here. But right now, sometimes we are not comfortable to go outside to visit our friends.
Because of the unrest that's been going on, you mean? Because of the protests and the violence?
Yeah, that's right. Yes, that's right.
So what's going on in Yemen right now? We're asking callers what stories in the news are of particular interest to them. Also, you've got the Eid celebrations going on. What's going on there in Sana'a?
Okay, first of all, today is the first day of Eid, which is when people, Muslim people, go to pilgrimage in KSA. So we are celebrating for that. Really, it's very good to celebrate and have fun, because we visit the whole family. We gather and visit each single house.
And so what about this year for you? Are you going to be doing anything special?
Actually, I'm still studying. I'm planning to finish, inshallah, this year, and maybe I will travel to KSA. I'd like to travel there.
What are you studying?
I'm studying accounting.
You know, it's funny. We've gotten a few calls from accountants, you know, since we started the show, and so we seem to be popular among accountants and engineers. We often get calls from accountants and engineers. So you like working with numbers then, is that right?
Yeah, I think all people who studying accounting, he likes numbers and stuff like that. And we have to put in our mind that accounting we can find in everywhere. It's have a majority of work, so you can work in everywhere. They need us.
Well, great. Well, so what about we're asking all our callers today if there's a particular story in the news that you're reading about because you're interested in it. I mean, we've got the government shutdown continuing here in Washington, although it sounds like there's some progress being made, possibly on a deal. You've got the Iran nuclear talks going on. What is there a story going on that you're following right now?
Actually, as you know, here in Yemen, we just went through a revolution year. Mm-hmm. So we have many problems here. So we are just focusing here about the problems here in my country. because, you know, even the most important problem that we face here is the electricity. Actually, there is a bully people who destroy the electricity. We suffer from this. Sometimes we cannot have electricity for 2 days or 3 days. Mm. So it's a big problem.
Well, how are things compared to, you know, when you had the revolution, when the President Saleh was forced out? How are things now compared to then?
Actually, there is some differences, some good, some are some bad, but we have to go through it. For example, in the past regime, in the previous regime, we suffering in each deal that we need to have with the government. We have to bribe the soldiers or a person who is in responsible to do our job. But nowadays, it's comparing to the previous, we don't have this problem. We have our work done without any money paid.
Mm.
And there is some problem with the security. Nowadays, it's bad because some people like to have problem here, to, for example, to stall and to destroy the electricity, to have their own achievement fulfilled, just their self. They don't care about the others.
Here, today is the first day of Eid al-Adha. I see a lot of people from another country, like Australia, United States, and London, from anywhere. They came here to see, like see culture and anything here.
Now, so what about your family back in Iraq? Have you been in touch with them? How are things there right now for Eid?
Yeah, but not. Yeah, they are happy, but not okay, because there is a lot of a problem in Iraq. It's not safe. Yeah.
Right.
They spend all the time at home. Yeah, I call him today in the morning. They said, my family said, we are stay at home. We can't get out anywhere.
Is there a story that you're following either locally or internationally that really is interests you right now? What's on your mind?
Oh, yes. Let me to be honest with you. I don't like political issues, but because Iranian people, they are near from they are never for our countries, and they sometimes I hear some news from the Washington from the negotiation between Washington and Iranian government. I'm take care of that, because Iranian people, they are in the bad situations. They are very really they are very poor. Some Iranian people come to my countries, to my region. They are working very hard to provide their families a good life, but they can't.